Vienna, Austria welcomes the best figure skaters in Europe. Italy sends its best dance team. Fusarpoli and Mergaglio having a breakthrough season. France is represented by Anissina and Pesaro. Right now, the best team in the world. The Russians send world champions Maria Butyrskaya and Alexei Yagudin. The 2000 European Championships, next on Sportsnet. So the road to Nice, France and the World Championships is getting shorter and shorter, a month away from the Worlds. And hi, everybody, Rod Black along with Debbie Wilkes. Welcome to our coverage of the European Championships. Next step, the Worlds. And every year at this time when we talk about Europeans, we usually talk about the Russian stranglehold. The Russians have been so dominant in so many disciplines for so many years.
And you're not going to be disappointed with it this year either. Certainly in three out of the four events, the Russians are definitely the favorites. I think there's a couple of new wrinkles down in dance because the defending champions Krylova and Ovsyannikov are not there, out for the season due to injury. So we are going to see a new champion there. But as far as the other events, the singles and the pairs, it's like revisiting Russian nationals. We have, of course, in men, Alexei Yagudin, two-time world champion, who will be trying to regain some ground. He lost at Russian nationals. Evgeny Plushenko beat him there. Also in the women, we have the reborn and dynamic Irina Slutskaya, who has just been a breath of fresh air this year, beating the world champion Maria Butyrskaya. Pairs also dynamite, Berezhnaya, Sigurdulidze, Petrova, Tikhonov. I think it will be whoever skates the best that day.
It's almost like, I don't want to compare it to wrestling or maybe golf or basketball, it's almost like one-on-one, two featured performers in each event.
Although, I have to tell you that down the list, there is a lot of talent, some skaters that have been around for a while that are really putting their act together this year. Dmytrenko in men, a very exciting performance at Europeans, and other skaters that you will come to love.
So the big question is, how important is the Europeans? Do you lay it down now? Do you get the gold medal and maybe leave a little bit left behind as you head towards the Worlds? Or do you try to save a little bit as you peek towards Nice, France?
I think if any skater takes a breath and tries to slow down for Europeans, it's a big strategic mistake. This is a very, very important event from the judges' point of view and in terms of skaters gaining momentum for the Worlds, as you say, just over a month away.
So the momentum is continuing, and we will continue when we come back. Alexei Evgeny, the men's short program highlights next from the 2000 European. In Vienna, Austria, the 2000 European Championships, the men's free skate still ahead. And after qualification, Alexei Yagudin, the world champion, was the leader in one group, Evgeny Plushenko the leader in the next group, and then this in the short program.
Beautiful quad toe loop, not in combination. The combination for Yag was the triple axel, followed by a somewhat shaky triple toe.
Here is Alexander Apt, another one of the talented Russian skaters.
Beautiful triple axel, a not-so-great combination with a double toe on the end of that.
And then Ivan Denev.
Bulgarian skater, very hot on the trail in the last season or two, and he was right up there too, third in his qualifying round.
And of course, the talented team, Evgeny Plushenko with a quadruple jump of his own.
Determined to make a big mark this year, already defeating Yags at Russian National.
So two quads in the short program performed for the first time ever at the European Championships. And Dmitry Dmytrenko also into the mix.
He's skating very well this year. The short program was excellent. Finished third in the short. The characteristic one-foot footwork sequence.
So the rivalry between Yags and Plushy, is that what you're calling
him? That's what we're calling him.
Alexei Yagudin and Evgeny Plushenko. And now the free skate from Ukraine, Dmitry Dmytrenko. Remember back in 1993, seems like such a long time ago, Dmitry won this championship. He is the veteran among all the teenagers.
You're right, he has been on the scene a long time, Rod, but he's only won his nationals once, the same year that he won his European title. Very good triple axel opening. Jumps are going very well for Dimitrenko in this skate. Triple flip, downgraded to a double. Even if Dimitri has a tough time with the jumps in a program, he is a very good choreographer, a lot of detail. And because he's a musician as well, I get a real feeling in watching his programs that he's paying attention to every note.
Quite often, he has composed his own music for his skates.
Second triple axel attempt. Weak on the landing. Good change of pace in the middle of the program. The music from the soundtrack from the movie Scent of a Woman. When Dimitri first came on the scene back in the early 90s, he was really touted as being a great talent. And then because of training conditions and lack of money to support his training, when he's come to events, he's almost looked like he's been unprepared, not well trained. Here, for the first time, I had the feeling that he could go longer than the 4.5 minutes.
It has been an interesting ride this season for Dimitri Dimitrenko, maybe even a bit of a renaissance. Back to those early days in the 90s when he was winning consistently. The sense of musicality and performance perhaps second to none in the field. Unfortunately, these days you still have to have that four-letter word known as the quad.
It's the only weakness. He can do it, but did not do it today. The biggest jump for Dimitri today, the triple axel in combination. Tiny bit of a 2-foot landing on the second jump. There's the takeoff. You see a very strong, explosive takeoff. This was the second triple axel, the one that he couldn't get out into landing position. But he really looks at music and at choreography with special eyes. He's always looking for unique and different moves. Lets the music tell him what to do. That's what good choreography is all about.
The 26-year-old from Kiev in Ukraine. And his marks, 5-7 from the Slovakian judge, down to a 5-3 from the French judge.
You'll notice there's a Canadian judge on the panel.
5.4 from Canada's representative. And better marks for presentation of course, and with earlier skaters, Dmitry Dmytrenko right now stands above them, but keep in mind we have a world champion to
drive
when it's beamed to Russia, of course, and here is the teenager, 17 years old, second after the short program, but a very close second. Recently crowned Russian champion, beat Alexei Yagudin in his own country, and now would like to be crowned European champion.
Very few skaters have this kind of sparkle. He is the perfect combination of technical, athletic moves and showmanship. I mean, it gets kind of corny at times, but you gotta love it. He's got the energy to pull it off. There's
quad,
the quad,
triple, double, and falls out of it. I still can't believe that he's been able to pull that one off this season.
Yeah, in the Grand Prix series, he did do several sequences that included quad, triple, double. He's the kind of skater that, Rod, that when he gets a couple of good elements under his belt, you can just see his temperature rise. The energy increases, he gets better and better as the program goes on. Second triple axel right in front of the judges. Taking his time, enjoying even the slightest movement, the shortest edge, playing it for all it's worth. And isn't it nice to see a skater with a program that doesn't look like jumping from one end of the rink to the other, like a hockey puck that goes from one jump to another. Refreshing, dynamic, completely enjoyable.
The whole package.
Ooh, he started to tip on the triple loop. Got a hold of it by the time he landed. And he does the Bielman.
You simply run out of adjectives when you talk about Evgeny Plushenko. He is a brilliant young talent who now has come to a point where he rarely makes mistakes. And when he does, they aren't glaring mistakes.
He's grown up a lot in terms of presentation in the last year. You see him taking his time. He's very patient in the way he presents the program. His coach, Alexei Mishin, who we have seen a couple of shots of, is a great tactician. He knows the kinds of buttons to push to get his skaters to perform. Tough taskmaster, too.
And a man who has been known, his coach, Mishin, as someone who has developed great jumpers. And I think of the triple axel, you think of the quad. He also helped with Alexei Yagudin and Alexei Ermanov. And here is the quad triple-double.
The third jump, a double loop. You can see the left shoulder starting to tip on the takeoff. The body not over the edge on the landing.
Most skaters would have fallen into the boards, though, and he didn't.
No, he has very quick response. Beautiful triple axel, triple toe loop.
Well, he is amazing, and Alexei Yagudin now knows what he has to be. He will have to skate near perfectly if you judge these marks. 5.8s and 5.9s for Evgeny Plushenko.
Interesting to compare this program with Yagudin because they are quite different in their whole philosophy. This is a very traditional program. Yagudin has been accused this year of kind of going the North American route. See what you think.
First place ordinals across the board. Evgeny Plushenko, second after the short program. And now he awaits his fellow countryman and his main rival, Alexei Yagudin. And here he is, the world champion two times in a row. Overcoming some recent equipment problems. You wonder if they will surface here or if he has any lingering doubt in his mind about that young teenager who he just saw skate.
And another thing he has to cope with, look at his right hand. He is wearing a cast. He fell into the board and broke a bone in his right hand. Now, when that comes to jumping, the feeling of a takeoff on a jump is so fine, it can throw his timing and balance off. Let's see what happens. Here is his quad. Whoa! Landed on the back inside edge, managed to pull it off. It was not pretty. This music from the soundtrack from the movie Broken Arrow. And when I talk about it being North American, it has a theme based on the soundtrack. Dramatic, very intense, very emotional. You're getting the job done with the jumps, but the landings are not flowing. They're not continuing with speed. He's having to work very hard to keep them clean. Top sequence there, going right from the triple flip with very little preparation into the second triple axel. A simple triple sow-cow. Problems on the landing, leaning out of the circle.
A game performance from the injured Alexei Yagudin, but it doesn't look like it will be enough to hold off Evgeny Plushenko, who may do it again to Yagudin, setting the tone for the World Championships.
Seeing these two skaters skate one right after the other gives you an opportunity to really assess each of their respective qualities. Both programs are extremely different. I found today that Yagudin did not have the effortless power that Plushenko had. He had a lot of little mistakes, nothing really glaring, but it was not an easy program to skate. The lean on the quad started out, the problem that continued throughout the program. He was having to fight for most of the jumps. The triple axel was a beauty. It went up nice and straight, but one of the few jumps that he didn't have to really struggle to land.
He is a master at the triple axel, which not too long ago was the barometer. It still is the barometer. You have to have the triple axel, but now you must have the quad. And I think the look on Alexei Yagudin is maybe a look of wonder as well. Arcs and not happy with the fact perhaps he's a runner-up.
Well, there's a real contest here, not just on the ice. Remember that just a few years ago, Yagudin was coached also by Mishin. When Plushenko came on the scene, there was some real rivalry there off the ice, and Yagudin changed coaches to Tatiana Tarasova.
They're not the best of friends.
No, they are not.
And the second place marks across the board means that Evgeny Plushenko is now a European champion. And can you believe what will happen and transpire in Nice, France? What a showdown. Add Elvis Stoiko to the mix and the others in the world. Whew. You've got tingles, haven't you? Plushenko, the gold medalist. Yakutin, the silver. And the rest of the men's results at the European Figure Skating Championship.